you didn't think we would do an AC Milan all-time 11 and leave out their fearsome rivals Inter, did you? That would have been ignorant at best and rude at worst. Inter Milan are, after all, the only Italian side ever to do what Man City did last season, win a League, Cup and European treble. They did that in 2010.
It will be the team from Syria who lift the trophy. Inter are the UEFA Champions League winners.
Inter, like Milan, have had their own successes in Italian and European football history. Their San Siro rivalry with AC Milan is one of football's truly iconic derbies, right up there with the Classico and others. And of course, as the clubs share a stadium, they share more than just a slice of history, not least in the original name of the ground. It's actually called the Stadio Giuseppe Meazza. Who was that guy? You'll have to keep watching to find out. So here we go with Inter Milan's all-time 11. In goals, it's the Brazilian shot stopper Julio Cesar, the first name on the team sheet during his time at the club and a key part of the 2010 treble winning team. Cesar was the number one for his national side too. He won 5 leagues with Inter and 14 titles there in total. He played over 300 games in 7 years in what was a ridiculously fruitful spell at the club. The captain of Internazionale's historic 2010 treble winning side was the veteran Argentinian fullback Javier Zanetti. This now club legend spent almost 2 decades there and played over 850 games. Zanetti was famous for long busting runs up and down the wing for Inter. He had quality when he reached the final third and he was rarely beaten when he was back defending. He won 5 leagues in his time and could play in a number of positions. His quality, his engine, his versatility and his leadership skills mean Zanetti was the perfect captain and could have played in any team he wanted on the planet. Another 2010 treble champ was Colombian centre-back Ivan Cordoba. This no-nonsense defender was a rock at the back and a nightmare for attackers as he was relentless and physical. Cordoba also won 5 Scudetto with the club over his 12-year career, winning 15 titles in total with 324 appearances. We'll take a break from the 2010 history with this next one, as alongside Cordoba in defence is a man who played for Inter back in the 80s, Giuseppe Bergomi. Bergomi is a famous and heralded one-club man, and whilst at Inter he won 3 UEFA Cup titles. A youth player at the club, who broke onto the scene in 1980, Bergomi played over 500 games for the Nerrazzurri. He finally got his hands on a league title with Inter then in 1989, no less than this loyalty deserved. Rewind another 20 years and you will find another one club man and one of Inter's top players of the 60s, fullback Giacinto Facchetti. Facchetti played an amazing 634 games for Inter and even scored 59 goals from the back line, including 10 in one season in 1966. He won an impressive 4 leagues, 2 European Cups and an Intercontinental title with the club. He even won the European Cup as Italy captain with the national side in 1968. Facchetti had a marvellous career. In the midfield is a famous Spaniard who, unlike many others, had spells at both Real Madrid and Barcelona. Between 1958 and 1960, one Luis Suarez shone at the Camp Nou as Barca won back-to-back titles. Suarez was then awarded the Ballon d'Or in 1960 and then became the most expensive player ever when he moved to Inter in 1961. He would go on to have great success with the black and blue side. He won 3 league titles, 2 European Cups and the Intercontinental Cup. He was a stellar talent. Another Argentine makes the starting lineup in the form of Esteban Cambiaso, another key man in the 2010 treble winning team. Cambiaso was a dynamic midfield player with a great set of all-round skills, a fantastic reader of the game with technical ability and a wonderful work rate. He was a key cog in the 2010 machine. The CDM scored 41 goals for Inter over the space of a decade from 04 to 2014. He played for the club 315 times and of course peaked with their unrivaled 2010 success. The final piece in our midfield trio was another star of the 2010 treble campaign, and a player that perhaps had his name on that Ballon d'Or trophy had it not been for the existence of Lionel Messi. The player in question is Dutchman Wesley Sneijder. Sneijder was a key part of the Holland team that came so close to winning the World Cup that year too. Had they won that game, he would have completed football in one single season. Nonetheless, his genius did not go unnoticed, and he was influential for Inter, the creative spark in that side. His trademark pass with the outside of the boot was always particularly delightful to watch, and he helped Inter to that historic treble. Back to the 60s we go, as the next name on the team sheet is Sandro Mazzola, another outstanding one club man. This is the most loyal 11 we've seen. Mazzola was a forward who won the Italian Golden Boot whilst at Inter, scoring 116 goals in over 400 appearances for the club. Famously quick on the counter and a smart finisher too, Mazzola was instrumental for the Nerrazzurri. He won countless titles and even came second to Johan Cruyff in the Ballon d'Or vote. In the middle of the attack is Brazilian sensation, El Fenomeno. Ronaldo Nazario was a wonder who made a massive impact at Inter Milan, and funnily enough, another star like Luis Suarez, who spent time at both Barca and Real Madrid. Ronaldo was a world record transfer who lived up to his billing despite a host of injury setbacks. In only 68 appearances for the club, he scored 49 goals, winning the 1998 UEFA Cup, captaining the side and winning two Ballon d'Or titles. Ronaldo is perhaps still somehow underrated, perhaps because of those aforementioned injury troubles, but he was electrifying, clinical and quite frankly magic with the ball at his feet. He was so young at Inter and he didn't play that much, but he was a true great and another world champion. Last but not least, the mystery man himself, Giuseppe Meazza, the man after whom the stadium Inter and AC Milan share was named. Meazza played 13 years for Inter and then two at Milan. Meazza scored 424 goals in the blue and black of Inter. Also known as the Little Boy, he had racked up 100 of those goals aged just 23. He led Inter to three Scudetto triumphs. Oh, and not to mention, he won back-to-back World Cups with Italy in 1934 and 1938. You might not have heard of him before, but now you can see why Meazza has the stadium named after him. A true Italy and Inter legend. What a team. World Cup and Ballon d'Or winners galore, trebles and countless Scudetto and European trophies. This all-time 11 would certainly take some beating. Don't you think? Hit subscribe and don't miss out on the next video.